400 now, right? Don't like that. So our 400 still can have time to build on. So the next thing is, yeah, in life, sometimes you will not live alone. You'll buy a flat. So what happens when you buy a flat? Wow. true and not true. Let me show you something. This is something very interesting. I got a lot of clients, young couple, they always ask me, Jin-ta, I'm going to get married soon and I'm going to buy a HDB flat. They always say this, very interesting. They say, should I show him? I don't know why they use this word. Should I show him my OA for HDB? What will your answer be? Show, really, why? No. If you borrow with HDB, HDB loan. HDB loan is 2.5% plus 0.1%. It's only at 2.6%. So, where else can you find such a cheap interest rate? Where can you find this 2.6% interest rate? Actually, very tough. Right now, banks' interest rate is low, but they haven't tell you the floating rate, the SIBOR rate. So when interest rate starts to go up, are you going to pay more or pay less? So if you are planning on a longer horizon, you should be taking the CPF low interest rate, 2.6%. Because if you don't have any other plans, so if you don't have any other plans, you'll be good not to show hand your OA, because it's quite easy to earn more than 2.6%. If you have attended some of the investment course from Cayden, looking through some of the investment opportunities, you will know that it is possible to get more than 2.6%. So should you show hand? No, the answer is no. I advise no. You want to ask why, can come and talk to me later. Okay, so this is what happened to me. At the age of 30, I proposed to my wife. I said, will you want to buy a HDB flat? So this is what happened. 270,000, this is the flat that we bought. So we always say, none in income, equality. So you pay 50%, I give 50%. This one must learn, please master this. So we co-share, 50% down payment, we put in about 13,500. So 50% co-share means I have to take about 121,500 of loan. And I take 30 years, long, so I can stretch the interest rate. So what happened here is, every month I only need to fork out $486. Affordable? Yeah, stamp duty, all this, compared to this, also quite small. First 180,000, 1%. Subsequent 2%, we calculate. Actually, just for illustration purpose, so we will not go through detail. But the amount that I'm paying on a monthly basis is only $500. So housing affordable in Singapore or not? You don't answer me, sorry, you don't answer me. You think about it. Yeah, that's why just now, I wanted to change this. But I have not enough time. But now, I think, what is your name, sorry? Mavis, you are very right. Right now, the HDB flat doesn't cost 270,000. So sorry for those who haven't got a flat. That is my story. That is my story. I was younger then. 270,000 was what I paid. Just to share, my cousin just bought one at the Punggol. Five room flat. 100 square meter, it is $500,000. So either way, you just take the monthly repayment will be about 1,000, almost there. So just for illustration purpose, this is what I'm paying. So if you are we cannot be comparing the HDB prices. In this HDB, yes. Well, we can choose where we want to live. You need not choose the expensive one. They are even more expensive maybe in areas in Novena, in Orchard. Yeah, way more HDB. Yeah. So my advice is, if you have enough money, go there. If not, you can always do some financial counseling and see whether you can afford the 700,000 kind of HDB. But strangely, why you want to buy such an expensive HDB? Anyway. Wow, we engage in this. I better call the who is the HDB minister. Who one? I don't know him. You know him? No, but just to be on the realistic side, right now not all the housing prices are so expensive. I'm not with the government, but half a million is five room. So if you don't want to stay next to the longkang, the river, it's way cheaper. If you want to stay near the river, then of course it's going to be much more expensive. So there are cheaper alternatives. So do not be so engrossed with the HDB pricing, because this is not the main purpose today. Okay, we are not going to discuss the HDB pricing. But typically, you can always go to the HDB website and see the selling price. So, just now I said, if you buy a flat, what will happen? Just now I heard someone say, wipe out your CPF. Yeah, actually, you can choose to do that, you can choose not to. But either way, based on my projection, if you after setting aside a minimum sum for the MediSave, then you'll flow to the special account, and after that, flow to the ordinary account. So the amount that I'm likely to get is about 1 million after I buy a flat. 270,000. That's for me, not for the younger generations. So 270,000 flat will cost me about 400,000 deep in my retirement planning. Now I only have 1 million left at the age of 65. So just now I say I need 1.8 million, and after I buy a flat, it's 1 million. So I need to do this. From here, I need to go to my retirement target of 800,000. Is that possible? 28 years old now, then under 65. So I did a simple Excel calculation. If I can achieve my CPF investment using OA and SA combined, with just 6%, I can hit about 1.8 million. All simple maths, nothing fanciful. So which also means that at that point in time, I start to invest at 6%, I will have achieved about 1.8. That is only on the assumption that I continue to work. My boss keep on employing me 3,000, giving increment 4% every year. But some of you are earning more than 3,000. Some maybe already earning 6,000, 7,000, 8,000. So there are already just a very simple assumption. So right now, just now we say what we can invest in. So I want to zoom down into details. So for your CPF savings, right? In fact, we can invest in all these things. I think in what people at the back may not be able to see. Shares, stocks and shares, property funds, typically we're talking about REITs, bonds, government bonds, gold and ETF, exchange traded funds. So these are the things that you can invest using your CPF savings. Okay, if you go to the CPF website, this is what you see. I never change anything. Exactly. OASA. So there are some of the things that are very interesting down there. Because you will see that some of the things that are offered in the ordinary account doesn't even hit 2.5%. So if it doesn't hit 2.5%, then why do you want to put money in the ordinary account? If you look at the SA, special account gives you a 4% type of return. So some of the instruments here may not even give you 4%. So you must ask yourself why you want to invest using that. Okay, so there's always a catch. So some of you may already have the answer. So this is the exact line that I copied from CPF website. For ordinary account above 20,000, you can invest the rest. That's a catch. Haven't finished yet. So for special account above 40,000. But for ordinary account, there's this special clause called investable savings. So investable savings for shares, property funds, bonds, you can only use up to 35%. For gold instrument, 10%. So how you know how much you can get? The answer is yes. You can always check with CPF and stuff. But simple calculation here, if your ordinary account here has 50,000, you include those that you already use for investment and education. You add together, and for example, in this case, 50,000 in the ordinary account. Now in investment, you have used 12,000, and then education, you use about 10,000. Now investable savings is 72,000, of which you can only use 35%. You cannot use all. So far, so good. Confused?
$20,000?
Oh, no, that's not considered inside. So just look at the balance, account balance. So this is the thing. You need to either you do your own calculation or you can always check with the CPF person. So all the information are down there. Okay? 35% for stocks and shares. For gold, 10%. Just keep these two numbers in mind. And then the keyword is investable savings. Okay? This question everybody asks the same. Should you invest your CPF special account? And before anything, I just ask everyone, do you know how much CPF is giving you in terms of interest? In the website itself, it writes 4 to 5%. Because the first 60,000, it gives additional 1%. So the question is whether you should be investing your special account. So the thing is, it depends on your appetite. Risk reward appetite. If you are very confident, if you know what you are exactly doing, and you are very confident that you can earn 6%, 8%, you can do that. Nobody is stopping you. But however, if you look at the risk reward, 4%, and if the instrument is giving you 5%, the risk that you are taking just to earn the additional 1%, is it worth it? Is it going to be worth it? You must ask yourself this in terms of risk and your reward. So typically, if you are not the adventurous type, I will advise you 4%. Okay lah. Why not? Bun-bun one, steady 100% can get the 4%. So just to share one of my clients, when he opened up his CPF account for me to see, I got a shock of my life. He just told me one simple thing, which caught me thinking. He said, that I do not know how to invest. So every time I see big money in the OA, I transfer to my special account. Oh, I got a shock of my life, open up, 300 over 1,000, 38 years old, Malaysian, PRO. So he never buy house, huh? Quite impressive, huh? He started off earning $500 in Singapore at the age of 18, now he's 38. Impressive to me, I say, wow. So, this is the thing. No right and wrong, depends on your risk appetite. Okay, so now you know how much you can invest using your CPF. So, the next question is, where can you do your shopping? So, typically, if you go to the SGX website, you can always see this view all CPF investment scheme. So, the moment you click on that button, you see all this, why come up? It means it can be invested using a CPF. So you can always look through. And in this website itself, you can typically get shares, property funds, bonds, ETFs, gold ETF, all from here. Very simple, nothing special. Other platforms like Fund Supermart, you can also see. And there's like Fund Singapore, you can always go there and take a look. They always list up the investment that is available under CPF investment. So some of the things are like REITs. REITs are also down there.